Come on and open your eyes. Breathe deeply now. I am with you. You are the love of my life. You are my one creation. You are eternity. And that will never change.
I feel like we're all ready to drop already. So relax through the logistics. And whatever, you know, you don't have to pay so strict attention to things because everything will be on the whiteboard in the kitchen. But mostly we just wanted to make sure that if you had any questions and any logistical type things right now, we could cover that. And we'll spend 15 minutes just kind of going over some of the things.
Yeah.
Some of the things that
I think we need to use this, because I see you doing with your head. So. Do we need, can we put this on? There we go. We want everyone to be able to hear everything. Thank you. I saw your hand doing it.
Yeah, I was just saying that just to relax and listen to the logistics that we're going to be going over. But that also, not to get too stressed about it, because there will be everything will be on the wall in the main kitchen. That's where you can go there and look to find all the information that we're going to be sharing tonight. Okay, so it's mainly just to be as clear as we can, so that we can flow together in the silence, and how we're going to communicate, and some of the just the basic things that are good to know. So that as we're living in community together in this silence, that things can flow swiftly, flow easily for us. So Tamara here has been putting together pages of logistics, and we've got them down now. So we're going to turn it over to her and let her share with you some of the things that will be helpful for this week together.
So good to turn my phone off. You're all here. It's such an honor. Whew. Okay. So yeah, as Suzanne said, the most important thing to know is that everything I'm going over with you will be...
It's like unidirectional. I think you have to tilt it like you're eating an ice cream cone. Like,
okay.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay. So, including the stuff that they went over with you on your tours, that will be up on the board so you can look at that stuff again. Like, oh, what time did they say this was? Or stuff like that. So, and then everything I'm going over with you now will also be up there. So, I'm just going to start where I start. So one of the main questions I've been asked is, when is David going to be speaking? So we'll start there. So we're going to have, the way it's going to work is everything on your retreat is optional. So you could actually spend the entire 6 days completely in silence in your room if you feel to. But the way that we're going to work it is that when you hear five bells, that means that David's going to be speaking. And we're going to have time slots for those so that if you wanted to take a walk or something, you wouldn't have to worry, like, oh, what if I miss the five bells? So it'll either be from 10 to 12, 2 to 4, or 7 to 9. And that'll be up on the board. And then we'll also ring five bells when David's going to be speaking. And then for lunch, which is at 12:30, and dinner, which is at 5:30, it'll be three bells. And so if it's not 12:30 or 5:30 and you hear three bells, it means there's an impromptu gathering happening. So if you can just try to get here within like 15 minutes, and then if you have to come in late, that's fine too. Just do so quietly.
They'll be at the same times, too. They'll be 10 till 12,
2 okay.
to 4, or 7 to 9. They're the session times.
Right. Yeah. And those times will be written up on the board. So that's when, when gatherings do happen, those will be the possible times that they will happen. So you'll be able to kind of, you have an idea of when you could go for a walk or take a nap or pray. Okay. So there's going to be morning meditation in here at 8:45 every morning. You're free to come. Please try to be on time. You can leave as you feel. And then just please leave quietly. Our lovely Dylan here has offered to do movement sessions in the mornings as well. So those are going to be at 9:30. That's 9:30. And that'll be on the board as well and where it will be. So we'll let you know, like, the yard by the fire pit, the yard out here, so it'll be very specific where things are going to be at. I should have brought water. Can I have some water?
Have some water.
Okay. Thank you. All right, so Suzanne and Kirsten are going to be doing... Yeah?
Prayer sessions.
Okay.
One-on-one prayer sessions.
One-on-one prayer sessions as it feels and as it comes in. So we'll be putting sign-up sheets for those in the mornings, and then they'll just put what hours are going to be available. So basically, I'm sure you're getting the idea that, like, those boards are kind of your go-to boards in there to just see. So you can check on them in the morning, and that's where you'll get an idea of the happenings of the day and when you can do one-on-one prayer sessions and when there'll be gatherings and movement classes and things like this. So if you do want to attend something, just try to be on time. And if you like, some of the rooms I know are kind of far, some people are down in the campground, so if you're a few minutes late, that's okay. Just please be quiet. The bunk rooms, there's quite a few of you lovelies up there. So there's going to be a lamp on in each room until 10:30 at night, where we have a designated person who will turn the lamp off. If, say, you're up there and you still feel like you want to be up, you're not necessarily ready to go to bed or whatnot, you can be in here or in the chapel. There'll be a light on in here. Or the kitchen. Yep, those rooms are all available to you. We just prefer you didn't sleep in here. Thank you. Or the bathroom. Or the chapel. Okay. Coffee's going to be available in the morning at 6:30. And once the pot's out, then no more coffee for the rest of the day, but tea will be available all day long. And we have some of you have already seen and already put your names on glasses, which is amazing. So those glasses are your glasses for this whole week that you're here. And there's already tape on them and a pen by them, so you can just put your name on them, and you can either keep them there, you can take them to your room, you can bring them in here, although we ask that only water be brought in here. And if you bring coffee or tea or something, just bring it in something that has a lid on it, like your water bottle or something. We just don't want any spills in here. Okay. So, like I said, meal times are 12:30 and 5:30. There'll be bells for that.
Breakfast.
Breakfast is from 7 to 8:30, and it's just going to be set out. So, you can... Actually, would you explain the dish situation for me, please? Like how, where you want people to put their dishes and how that's going to go. This is our kitchen angel.
I haven't figured out the logistic totally yet, but there'll be a place for you to put your utensils in. And we're going to have some kind of container where you'll just shovel out the food that's in your plate, you know, just so that the food goes in one container. And there'll be another container where you'll put your utensils in. And then you just put your plate. If there's a water place, you know, then you could just do the soak kind of. And then just put it down on a counter. If there's not, then just put your plate down on a counter. But I think it might figure out a swishy swish. Utensils and for the food. It'll be very easy. For the food, utensils, swish, swish.
Very nice.
I guess the most important thing for you to know is you won't be doing your own dishes. We're really trying to avoid too much, you know, activity back where the cooks are and where all the prep's happening. So as much as we can keep people on this side of that counter, that's the way it's going to go. Okay. There is a stand-up water cooler in the kitchen. I don't know if everybody saw it, but it's on the east side. Sunset's over there. It took me 3 months before I figured out where west and east was. So, sun is at the west, and it's over there. So when I say east, I mean that wall.
So and water. The water here is very good. It's well water. You can drink it right out of the tap.
Yeah.
And there's a container outside, too, with a little spigot.
Yeah. And if you happen to be in one of the domes, or the what we call cocoons that also look like bread loaves, you probably have water in your room. So if you run out, you can just come over and fill it up at the water cooler. So we have, I'm sure all of you noticed when you were taking your tour, that we have 3 bathrooms. So, we have these lovely porta-potties. They're very clean. They're wonderful. And we're just really encouraging when you can, please use those. It's easier on our septic systems. So, yeah, when you can use those, that would be really gentle on the septic system. And then anybody using the outhouse, we also have 2 outhouses further to the east. And those have little buckets in them with some stuff you just shovel right in after you go potty. Okay. There is a bath in the bathhouse. You all passed the campground on your way here. So the people driving your shuttles might have pointed it out to you. There's actually a bath down there available to you with candles by it. And there are showers down there as well. I'll explain the shower sheet next. But there are showers down in the campground. The water down there is not for drinking. So if you just feel to go take a bath with some candles or whatnot, you can find your way down there. And if you can't, you can see it from the swing. So that's where that is. And you'll see it's got a ramp going up and steps going up to the... Okay. So now to the sign-up sheet for the showers. So it's right now it's on the corkboard in the kitchen. And so the way that it's set up is that everybody will be signing up for 1 slot, which will be for every other day. So one of the sheets says Saturday, Monday, and Wednesday, and then the other sheet says Sunday, Tuesday, and Thursday. So you'll sign up for a specific time, and then that will be your time every other day. And they're 15-minute slots, but we're recommending 5-minute showers, just because it'll be easier on our whole system.
Yeah, and if there's some reason that you really feel like you would like a shower every day, that can be arranged. But we're just asking everybody to just step back a little bit from all of that and just to relax. And every other day we felt was good with 2 showers and almost 40 people. So,
What about the? We have a hot tub too. It's not many monasteries you could
have a hot tub. The 21st century monastery.
So basically, you say, okay, I'm showering every day, but I'm going to soak.
They have to shower.
Meditate in the hot tub. So we have hours for that too. Very generous hours.
We love it when you shower before you go in the hot tub, especially with this many folks. So, and yeah, you should have. The hot tub is for your use. We're not using the jets for this silent retreat. And if you do use it and need to go in the bathhouse after, please use the front door, not the back door, because that back door is just for the retreat and staying above the bathhouse.
And the hours?
Yeah, they were from 8 a.m. And 10:30 till the lights off. I mean, you should be back in your room if you're going to bed.
There's some showers. You don't want showering after a certain hour.
No, we don't want showering.
So you can use.
But you can't take a shower.
8 a.m. to 10:30, and then if it's late, past what time? 9.
And what time did we? I think it was 9 o'clock. When's the last shower?
Oh, they're actually at 4:15 is the last shower.
Oh. I think we can go till 8. For the hot tubbers,
the hot
if you wanted to rinse off after a hot tub.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's like over 12. Mm-hmm. 12 or about 14 and a half hours a day. You want to... It's all optional. You might like that. It's pretty good to me.
A lot of healing has happened in that hot tub. A lot of healing.
A lot of healing over the years.
A lot of deep discussions, a lot of silence.
A lot of meetings.
Oh, yeah, lots of great stuff in the hot tub.
Okay. We also have a lovely sign-up sheet for volunteering for meal preps. So we're going to have meal prep teams. We already have a few main ones. So if you sign up for, there's lunch and dinner, and right next to where it says, like, Saturday lunch, it'll say what time you have to be there. And so really all it's going to entail, because we're going to be doing it in as much silence as possible. So all you're going to have to do is show up, and Dion will tell you exactly what to do. Swish. And you may be on cleanup, and you may be on making a salad or whatnot, but feel free. The sign-up sheet is in there, and we need 3 people for both meals every day. So if you feel like you want to be of service, and it's a really great way, if the, you know, to kind of help the mind. If you're just starting to feel a little restless or whatever, it's a really great way to just kind of practice the mindfulness and while doing a task. So that's what we do all the time here, and it's beautiful. Mm. So that's in the on the board in there as well, and you can sign up right after we're done here. You can sign up in the morning. So just to keep in mind that during that, there's just really the only talking would be if there's a really important question, if you just didn't understand, because she'll be very clear with her direction, and we just want to keep it, you know, just really maintain the silence during those service opportunities. There's going to be a little section on the whiteboard in there as well that says notes for the steward, which is me. So if something like, you know, if you have a snake in your room, or some like critical
emergencies. Law of suggestion.
I'm trying to make the point, like, emergencies.
And just to ease your mind, the snakes are all hibernating now.
It's all a reflection of mine. I've been out here all these years. I've never seen one. But everybody draws forth.
In 6 months.
Yeah. They're transformation symbols. Shedding the skins.
Exactly. The point was, I don't want a bunch of little silly notes on there.
That might have been easier to say.
Goddamn snake, okay?
I don't want silly notes.
especially for people that are in the further out spaces. I think we're actually going to have a few moonless nights, so please remember to bring your flashlights when you come for anything in the evening, even if for dinner, because it starts to get dark. And we've got solar lights out there and stuff, and we've done our best to make it, you know, easy, but yeah, just carry those flashlights. We don't want to, yep, just carry those flashlights. Please don't start any fires. There will be probably some scheduled fires, and those will be on the board, so look out for those. We might have some sunrise fires. This little fire pit out here will have a log in it every night, and there's chairs and a little bench, so if you feel to just meditate with the fire, feel free to do so. There's chairs up here, so you can pull one in if there's already people sitting there. There's a pile of blankets in the back there that are for the lawn, so if you feel to lay out on the lawn, there's some blankets and a few pillows. Just please return them when you're done. And every single person here should have a throw in their room. So we don't, if tonight is any indication, I don't know if it's ever going to get cold in here for this to matter, but if you tend to get cold, we don't have enough blankets in that little basket over there for everybody, so you can just bring the blanket from your room and just remember to take it when you leave. And the chapel and the gathering room are for your use for meditating and prayer. Please feel free to use them. I've done so much healing in this room. I've shed so many tears in this room. Please, please, please make sure to turn off your lights and fans whenever you leave your room. Lights, 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 off, 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 fans, 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 off, off, off. All right, this is the last thing. So a lot of people have been wondering when how they can get books and CDs. And so I put a basket over there, and basically the price list is on there. And tomorrow morning, I believe all of our products will fit, or the merchandise will be able to fit on the table there. Nicholas, we're going to join on that. And so, if you brought cash or check, you can just put it in the basket there. We're just going to do it on the honor system. So as you feel to, you know, look at the books and maybe get something, then you can just do it like that. So it's just so we can maintain the silence. So you don't have to be like, oh, how do I stay in silence and ask somebody if I can get this book? Okay.
You did it.
She has worked so hard. It's beautiful.
She has been done through.
No, I haven't done anything.
That's why it went so well.
There's been no way. All right, so are there any questions, anything I didn't cover? Jeffrey.
First, let me say flawless job. For the one-on-ones, where do you want the people to go? So that they don't
that's a good question.
Look at us, we're like...
the one-on-one prayer meeting.
Yeah, I will go into my room, which is the octagon.
We'll come and get the people, won't we?
They didn't think of that one.
Like, then there's a finite time.
Yes.
Or I could come and sit here on...
Yes. I have a great idea. Yeah, that's a great idea.
Come and sit here and we'll come and collect you.
Yeah. Just sit.
The porch.
Sit right here in one of these chairs.
And then
we will appear. And
indoors or outdoors chairs?
Right out.
Outside, on the deck.
Depends
on the weather.
How about the bench that's in front of the octagon?
The swing bench.
No, the little stone bench.
That's a step. Sit on the step.
Pine juice.
Okay, no, she's
pine juice.
Just pine juice. It's too sticky.
Yeah, if it's warm enough, just sit here on
the
stick.
That's good.
Yeah.
Okay, he's getting
it. Here's the official answer.
Official answer, yeah. If it's cold, come and sit in here. Yeah. And if it's nice and warm, sit outside on the end of the deck.
Good. Great.
We will come and find you.
Great.
Oh.
Thank you, Jeffrey.
You know, we really don't plan anything anymore, and it's very, very spontaneous, which we love. And so this is a very organic retreat. It will just be like we just have the basics so that we know that the mind can rest and you know the basics, but we really are enjoying this. not planning, not having everything worked out. So there will be moments when we have no idea what the answer is, but we'll find it very quickly together. So,
just on that note with the one-on-one prayer sessions as well, just, yeah, really be in prayer about it. The purpose of them is that you need help. That's what they're for. And I don't want to talk too much because I'll go into our content, but the main purpose of being here at the retreat is to allow yourself the spaciousness to go into your own mind and see what is there and listen from within. And so something that might seem like a major disturbance, you know, in the first hour or two that you're here, just give it a little time and be with it, with the spirit and prayer, and let some of those answers come to you. And so, yeah, I wouldn't jump too quickly to putting your name on a sign-up sheet. Just let it be, let it percolate. And then if there's something, if you're really stirred up and you're like, whoa, I need help, and you get to a point where you can't sink, you can't drop, then that's what those sessions are for.
I have a question about the fans upstairs. It's pretty warm in there, even for sleeping. Can that fan be without the light, the fan left on in the all night? Or, you know, on low, there are a couple speeds, so I turn it down to a low speed.
Yeah. I think on low it's nice to circulate.
Heat might be on. Better, we should check that too. I don't know whether it is. But.
No, in the canyon room, the heat's not on.
Talking about upstairs.
Yes. You probably will not need the heat with this many
a lot
people.
Of bodies in there now. Yeah.
Okay, that's fine because you said turn it off.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, to have the fan on low feels pretty good, just because there's so many people in the room. Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah,
just turn them off when you leave the room.
I think up in there you can just leave those, but like we have fans everywhere. We have fans in most of the private rooms. We have fans in the bathhouse. Yeah. Which makes a noise, so it's good to turn those off. But I think the bunkhouse feels good to leave it on low.
Yeah.
And if anyone in those rooms actually gets cold, in the closet in this room, there's extra blankets. There's a whole pile of extra blankets, and that is for both rooms. So if you're in this room and you're getting cold, you can walk into this room and go into the closet and get a blanket.
What about the sulfur in the bathhouse?
Down below,
so it's not a surprise.
Okay.
The water down at the campground in the bathhouse, it has a strong sulfur smell. So that's why it's not for drinking, but it's fine for washing in. For washing. Yeah.
And the smell doesn't stay
and
on you.
The smell
you.
Doesn't stay on you. So. It smells, but it doesn't make you smell.
So it actually does clean.
Yeah. So,
little things.
So if you go down there for a bath and you're like, whoa, is there something
But
wrong?
There's bubble bath, so you can... We're in the desert.
I'm happy that there's water.
Yeah.
I had when we were down at the campground, I actually, we hired a man to come and drill and try to find water down there. So he drilled. I don't know how many hundreds of dollars it was per foot that he kept going down and down and down and down. And it started off in the morning, and he was still drilling. I said, "Well, did we hit water?" Sounds like the pioneer days. Did we hit water? No, no. So then at lunchtime, I had to say to everybody at the expression session, "Everybody pray that we hit water." I said, "We never ask you to pray for specifics." this is
but
like hundreds
foot.
Of dollars per foot. And he's drilling down through what shale, rock, whatever it is. So when I hear that there's sulfur water down there, I'm just happy that he, right after
he
lunch,
hit.
He hit water. I said, "Okay, everybody." We all threw our arms in the air. "Thank you, Jesus." Instead of land ho, we got water. Yeah. So we're very grateful. Yeah.
Is there any more questions?
What about logistics? Expression sessions, are they they're not part of a silent retreat, are they?
No, you guys will go over all that.
We'll go over that. We actually just intuit it.
We have it in mind.
So, what she's referring to is at the monastery in our communities, we do expression sessions. We will probably do an altar session on Monday is the thought, but it's very intuitive, it's very spirit-given, so we just wait until the prompt comes, and there could be an opportunity for us to come together and just lift up whatever's in the mind, whatever's feeling like it's pressing on you, and just give it to the prayer circle. It's very, very powerful, it's very beautiful, so that'll just be an intuition, and that, like Tamara said, everything is optional. So if you're feeling the need for something like that, then you come. If you're not, then you just continue to be in your flow. Everything that we do is just here to support the mind so that it can rest and relax and drop back deeper into that inner listening and inner knowing. So, yeah, so we'll just, all those things will just be given day to day. Would just say, you know, some of you are in private rooms and some of you are in bunk rooms and shared. It's just a beautiful opportunity to be very mindful. And like when we talk about lights out at 10:30, it's just to honor those that want to sleep, and also just having the spaces to go to if you don't want to. But just be aware that you're in a room with, you know, 8 other people. And also I was feeling like the toilet upstairs, it's all women upstairs, which is nice. You know, you guys don't really need to flush the toilet all night long, you know, you really don't. And maybe the one that's up in the morning and where it's, you know, because you can hear it quite loudly. So just little things like that, you know, you don't have to flush the toilet. And yeah, so just to be aware that you're sharing the space and, yeah, just a mindfulness.
One last thing I just remembered. There's going to be snacks out on the tables during the day, like fruit and trail mix and granola bars. So once again, we're just, yeah, it's not to go and just like open the fridge and say, oh, this looks good. We'll have whatever, you know, we'll have snacks out there. And when they're gone, they're gone. Okay.
So don't be a snack burger.
Ready to move it, yeah. No ordering pizzas up here.
What are the designated areas during the night if people can't sleep, if they want to just...
In here, in the kitchen, or the chapel.
Okay.
Or out on the, even out on the grounds is fine as well.
And there will be some kind of lights so people can just walk right in and not...
Everybody should have, we had everybody bring a flashlight. Yes, and if you didn't remember to bring one, we have some extras for those nights when you want to come out of your room and stuff. So
there'll be a light in here all night. There'll be a light on in the chapel and the fairy lights for walking around the grounds. So, oh, I wish you all the most beautiful retreat and sinking in. I'm very excited to sink in with you, and I honor the courage it took all of you to get here. This is beautiful. I'm really, really.
You can relax.
So amazing to be part of all this. So, thank you for including me.
Yeah.
Love you all.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. If there aren't any other questions, then we are going to start this evening session. Start this evening session with a beautiful, beautiful song. I think it's about 8 minutes long.
Are we going to talk a little more about the sessions?
Do you want to?
Yeah. I think there was a question about them.
I don't know.
I don't think we have much information, but I kind of heard, I thought there was a bit of a question. We have, I do feel, just to share, so we have, what is guaranteed every morning is the morning meditation that starts in here, and then the movement session afterwards. And then we have possible time slots where there could be a session.
Right.
So
we'll fill it in spontaneously.
Sorry?
Or there could be a meditation session?
There could be a session. It could be a movie session. It could be a group meditation. We have some beautiful guided meditations and a music meditation. It could be another music and movement meditation. It
could be a walk.
It could
group
be
walk.
A guided walk.
Guided
to the river.
Walk. Could be a healing touch session. There'll probably be an angel bath session towards the end of the week. We've got a lot of beautiful ideas of things like that that have been coming in. So we're just going to feel into the flow and the vibe day by day and get a sense of what is the call. Is it active? Is it coming together with speaking? Is it very step back? And then the most there may be, maybe a guided meditation together. We'll just be sharing.
So you could repeat those session slots just so people know that that's, again, time to be around their, perhaps, instead of a long walk down the canyon or...
And we will ring the bell.
They're on the board.
Yeah, 10 till 12 in the morning. And lunch is guaranteed too.
12:30.
And then the afternoon, 2 till 4. And it's most likely that we'll know by lunchtime if there's something in the afternoon. Mm-hmm. So you don't need to hang around too long. Like, have lunch, check out the board before you disappear. And if there's nothing on there by 1:30, there's a good chance. Yeah. Nothing's happening in the afternoon. And then dinner is guaranteed. And then if there's an evening session, check the board at dinner time and you'll see if it's there. Mm-hmm. And it's a loud bell.
It's very loud.
So be aware of that too. If someone walks to the bell and puts the earphones on and you're sitting really close, then be warned. Cover your ears. It's a loud bell. You can hear it in the campground.
Yeah, I didn't ring it at its loudest because I knew most of you were already in here, so.
Yeah. Okay.
I guess that's how far afield can you wander?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to ask.
Yeah, that's a really good question. There's lots of, like you can see the road, the natural roadways.
Yeah.
You can walk up behind for many, many miles. It just depends on how far you want to go. The road is nice. It's a nice walk through the canyon if you just want to walk the road. So it's really, if you see a sign that says private property, I wouldn't recommend going across that. But for the most part, you're not going to see signs like that out here. But if you keep on the roads and stuff, and, you know, there's not traffic or anything, so it's a nice pathway for you to walk and not try to go through the sagebrush up the hill. So, yeah, there's plenty of places to roam. Yeah.
And our property is all up here. And then if you want to explore across Angel's Landing, like towards the domes, like as far as you'll see three domes, you can walk along the top of the cliff here. Mm. And you'll see three in a row. And then you can kind of come back this way. There's cocoons you'll see. And then down, you can take a walk down the driveway and down the little road to the campground. The whole campground is there, and you'll see a teepee near the other buildings. Then you can take a walk. There's overgrown paths, and then down there's the stage where we used to have the music festival. And there's another teepee down there, and just some lovely trees, some areas. So if you wanted to just go and be, you could. Our land doesn't actually go all the way to the river. And so some cowboy-type neighbours down in the canyon own that land, so we don't recommend that we want to roam on it too much. But if someone did have to slip down and sit by the river quietly...
That's fine. It's a very rare occurrence that they would ask you to get off their land, but it could happen.
So for the most part, stay on ours, but if you're really drawn...
We might mention, too, that there's actually... what's called a wash here. It's very, very rare, but it's unpredictable. But when you go down the driveway, or we actually have a couple driveways. Could they walk through either one. When you go down there, that's Sam's Wash Road. And they call it Sam's Wash Road because it's a wash. And very, very rarely, but sometimes a torrent of water will come down. I think Suzanne told me one time a woman parked her car there at one of her retreats.
It was the first silent retreat we first ever did out here.
Years and years ago, and that wash took that car out. I mean, I'm talking strong, and it's very, very rare, but if something like that happens, then we'll
just go.
Yeah, stay on high ground and don't try to swim in it or anything.
No, don't ride that wave.
No, it's very strong. And you can see down the campground's up on elevated ground, so it's not subject to the wash. The wash is just to the east of the campground. Mm-hmm. So if you hear some kind of rumbling, don't go down below the campground. And so, that's good to know. It's very rare.
Very
snakes can flash
floods.
You guys will be fine.
Now that you know about the flash floods and the snakes in your room, we want you just to relax.
Yeah. Again, the context is it's all a reflection of mine. So, people talk to me about snakes. I've not seen one. Scorpion, not seen one. I don't call forth those witnesses. I get bunny rabbits and
eagles flying.
Eagles. Beautiful birds circling.
Yeah, we have beautiful around, eagles. Yeah.
Like the Native American tradition, if actually across the way, that's actually Indian Native American land.
Across
we're looking
the river,
at across the river when we sit on those benches and look out. Mm. Very beautiful. And Native American tradition is rich with beautiful symbols of awakening. So it's beautiful.
And we do have our bunnies. The bunnies are very, very friendly. They won't let you touch them, but they'll be out on the lawns throughout the day. They're delightful. So. Okay. Yeah. Any other questions?
What time is the morning meditation?
8:45. Yeah. Breakfast will be done at 8:30. So you can show up between 7 and 8:30 or 7 and 8:15 probably for your breakfast. And it'll all be out. So there won't be any bell for that particular meal. Okay.
Yeah, I was just talking on the porch too about how this feeling over these recent weeks of just how Jesus is laughing with us all, at everything, and the lightness and joy and humor, it's just so, so strong in my mind. And then it was interesting, before coming over here, I just reached over to a book, I think it's right back there behind you. It's called The Mystical Teachings of Jesus. Mm. And so I just popped it open just to see if Jesus had anything to say to us. I popped it right open to How Will the World End? So anyway. It's for a silent retreat. I popped open How Will the World End? And then I read the first few sentences of the world will end in an illusion as it began in an illusion. And then he said, but it will be an illusion of mercy, an illusion of love. So it began with an illusion of hate, and it will end with an illusion of love and a happy dream and joy. And the world will end in laughter. And so, that's something to keep in mind, I think, on this silent retreat. You're just sinking inward to that light, that bubbling lightness. And I just keep experiencing more and more and more so strongly that how playful Jesus is, so playful. And he's literally, as he says, arranging time and space because he completed his part perfectly. He's now in charge of the plan, and he's playing with us with time and space, that it's all very light, even though the ego tries to judge it sometimes as very harsh or difficult or extreme or sacrificial, but that those are just false concepts projected onto it. It's very, very light and very playful. Mm-hmm. I keep getting these playful symbols always, so that's good to remember. And really, on the silent retreat, really have some fun. Give yourself a lot of opportunity and availability to have some fun in the silence. Mm.
Okay. Yeah, I feel like the opportunity that we all have together to sink in the prayer of our hearts, that's what brings us all together, is this desire for true connection with our source. And it feels like holy ground, really, that we all come together. And we just kept getting calls and calls and calls, people wanting to come. And it felt so beautiful that there's that kind of magnetism for the truth. And that's where we all meet, is in that stillness. And to be able to have such a gift of a place like this, in the middle of nowhere, from people have come from all over. It's like something, like a clarion call went out and we all answered together. And it feels really, really holy to me. Like we have been, you know, taking your names down, and it's like every day for a good solid month preparing. And it's such an honor to do that, because it's like welcoming a part of the mind back to its home, back to itself. And it's really what we live for. It's the only thing that we live for, is to go deeper and deeper into this authentic experience of awakening. Just to feel our hearts just open. And so as we look out the windows and we see each person arriving, it's like a blessing to the mind. The mind, it's not personal. It's like, but somehow, you know, when we come together, where two or more are gathered, there I am. And to just completely accept the gift that's given for this time together, and let go as best you can of any thoughts of anything other than what's happening in the moment for you. Let go as best you can of the concerns that you had in your life. If there's prayer time, just to open up. So when there's prayer time, which is all the time in the silence, it's like the prayer is the medium of the miracle. The prayer is the medium of the miracle. It's like, and we have a whole week devoted to the prayer of our hearts, to contact that which loves us. Like, you know, I think it's a Rumi poem that says something like, as you step back and you quiet the mind, that which loves you can find you. Mm-hmm. It's like, let's all be found, you know? Let's all be found. And in the silence, it can be very, you know, it can be very intense for some. Others drop quite easily. But just to allow, like Kirsten was saying, just be with it. Don't try to fix anything. Just be with it. Just be with yourself, you know. Just honor your prayer and step back. And there's something so powerful to be able to come together with this shared purpose, knowing that we've all come here for this divine purpose. There's nothing better. There's just nothing better. And so, yeah, as we just start this journey together, it's just a real invitation to the deepest part of your mind. To let go and let God and let yourself be. Just let yourself be. Just completely let yourself be. Don't put any pressure on yourselves during this time. A lot of people have never spent a day in silence. So, and this backdrop is just so supportive of that. It's so supportive. It's very spacious and lots of places for quiet contemplation. So I just feel really honored to just play my part and to welcome you so, so much from the heart. Like we're the same, you know? We are the same. And we've been in many, many, many retreats over the years. Probably all of us have. And I've seen such powerful shifts in the mind in silent retreats. And that's that prayer. And allowing the shift in the mind and the heart and to open up to an experience that is so beautiful. And if you're not experiencing that beauty and you're stuck, that's okay too. That's why you're here. And then you'll be supported. You're not alone. So, yeah. Feels really good. It takes a minute for the mind to settle down. It's like, just be patient. Just be patient. And, you know, usually in our meditations, it's just like a deep allowance of whatever thoughts are coming. Just let them come. Just let them come. Don't try to control anything. Let them pass by. Thank you. Thank you so much. And just, you know, I remember I was just telling David earlier when we were in Cincinnati years and years ago, I shared with him about this space, and I said, it's like a monastery, David. We'll just be like, we'll just go namaste to each other, and, you know, just the holiness and the sacred. So like, and tonight we were saying, it's here now. It's here now. This is what this place has been used for many, many years, for many, many purposes of healing, and it takes different, kind of a different vibe. But now it feels like, Kirsten was saying, this feels like what we're going to be doing more of, just joining in the silence and sharing when it's given. I don't think we're going to have that song. I think we'll do it at the end.
You mean Donna Marie?
Donna Marie? I think we just...
Yeah. We'll have Donna Marie at the very end.
Yeah.
Do you feel okay. to share, to talk, before we do the round?
Just to welcome everyone. I feel so honored that you would come into this stillness. And I like that there's a spaciousness with this silent retreat. This isn't like a necessarily like a Vipassana retreat or something where, you know, it's days of complete silence. There could be like an altar session if you go 2 or 3 days even and have some things bubbling up and, yeah, where some things can be talked about. We'll trust the Spirit will orchestrate that and use it for all of us, for healing, because there's nothing that we would keep hidden from the light. We want everything brought to the light, to the love. We give it back to love, to so that it may disappear and be dissolved, so that it doesn't preoccupy our mind, that we can rest. And a still mind is no small gift. For many of us, you know, it's been a lifelong journey to spirit, and we really honor that like a homecoming. It's a homecoming for us. I feel such grace, I feel such depth and honor to be coming together like that and share the space. We don't really try to ritualize it. You know, sometimes I've been to silent retreats where they say, you know, don't make eye contact, or, you know, it's to really give yourself opportunities to go in, but, you know, just let the Spirit, you know, if you want to look in someone's eyes or smile or whatever, you know, we're not ritualizing the silence, because it's our state of being, it's who we are. We're not trying to manufacture anything or force anything or make anything happen. Everything's optional too, so sometimes with retreats people will be like, thinking, should I be somewhere else, or should I be in this room, or this or this and this? You're welcome, you're loved, you know, wherever you seem to be. And there's an honoring that goes on with that. And it there can be an honoring and attentiveness with sessions, you know, because we come together, we want to be honoring of the what we're all sharing. But yeah, some will be coming from the campground or farther to the east, and so yeah, like was shared earlier, if you come and you think, oh, I might not get there on time, then let that thought go too. Just relax and know that you're always in the right place at the right time, and you're loved and welcomed. So it feels, yeah, it feels beautiful to be able to share this time and just watch what sessions come spontaneously, day by day, watch the whiteboard and and as we're going through it, if even there's something that comes on your heart that you feel would be really helpful, yeah, you can make a note to Tamara, or you can let one of us know. Something comes in very strong from spirit that you feel is important. Yeah, we're all here for the same purpose, so we want to be very inclusive about that, to be receptive to that. Just love you all so dearly, so great that we can share this together. And it's very precious. Thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you. Thank you. So I think we'll have a bit of maybe passing the mic and sharing from your heart maybe what drew you here, or if you want to share.
Yeah, I think I just realized it's a silent retreat, so everyone can share their name, but of course no one will be saying each other's names. So you really don't have to remember.
Isn't that nice?
That's nice.
But yeah, we'll pass the mic around, and if you'd like to share your name and the state where you came from, if you're in the US, or the country, if you come from further away, and just share the prayer of what brought you here, or yeah, whether it was just this real inspiration to get you here, or it's a real prayer for this retreat, it's something that you're really hoping to receive some help or insight or release with. And obviously there's a lot of us, so we don't, if you can just come to the present story without too much backstory.
Right.
Keep it meaningful and brief.
Trust that we'll get it. We'll get it. You don't need to explain it for us. But as well, know that we want to feel. We want to feel. What is your
heart?
Feel your heart. So, yeah, you don't need to kind of zip it. Just let it come from your heart. We want to hear it.
So I think the mic cable's not going to be long enough. So whoever wants to speak, mic can sit where
Jeffrey is. Oh, by where Jeffrey is. That's
if you're a quiet speaker, maybe.
You can sit here, Jeff.
If you feel like you can speak up.
Yeah.
So who wants to come to the hot seat?
I'll speak, but I don't need the mic. This is my first, I don't think I've ever been to a silent retreat ever for any affiliation, this or anything else. And 6 days, wow, it's just, I feel really peaceful and happy to be here. Calico was kind of the inspiration. She was coming, and it just felt good timing, and I love Suzanne, and I was really, it just felt like it really fell in place, and we had a lot of great conversations, Calico and I, on the way up here. Oh, my God.
They came from Santa Fe.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, we're from New Mexico. Well, Calico's now. She's a global citizen. I live in currently in Santa Fe, New Mexico. I like that word currently. Someone said that today here, and I went, oh yeah, currently. One of the topics that came up in our coming up here that I would like to have more clarity on is letting go of lack and loss, particularly lack. It seems like it could be money, but fill in the blank. Just whatever the mindset is that has seemingly have me see my life as things missing or lacking or not enough of something. And it's kind of the whole giving and receiving energy of, ooh, you know, how much do I want to give? It seems like in the area of money, but it really doesn't. It's money is a symbol, is like they all are. So anyway, I think that's enough said about that. Just, yeah.
Thank you, Kathy.
That's my last hurrah as a speaker for the next 6 days. Yippee! Bravo, Kathy.
Could we have the door open again? There's so we get some fresh air coming.
I'll just go around. My name is Rita. I'm from California, and it's so beautiful to be here. I'm already just feeling so peaceful, and I came here just to unwind out of my life and take this precious time to just go within and you know, go into the silence and quiet my mind and feel God's presence and feel that joy and peace. I already feel it. Just to have this many people with the same purpose is just profound. Mm-hmm. I've never experienced anything like this, so I'm really looking forward to it. And I just love you all.
Mm-hmm. Thanks, Rita.
I'm Calico, and I'm just so grateful to be here. I feel like I came for a personal devotion 2 months ago from Santa Fe. And when I left here, I thought, well, glad that's over. And I drove back, and by the time I got to Santa Fe, it was like, we're selling the house, we're finding homes for the dogs, we're getting rid of everything, and we're moving to Mexico to the monastery. You know, it was kind of like, my life has kind of turned upside down and inside out, but the beautiful part is, for the most part, my entire community in Santa Fe, and I've been in Santa Fe for 35 years, I was a chiropractor, and I got rid of the practice. I mean, I saw my last patient on Monday. The table went yesterday. It's just, I threw out my diploma and my degree because it's not needed. I'm really committed. I mean, I know Laverne, who's my contact in Mexico, she said, well, maybe we could just set it up for a month. And I said, oh, no, you're not getting rid of me that easy. I really get that my whole life purpose is to join with love and God and join with other minds in that devotion. And it's like nothing else really matters in my world right now. And I mean, to get rid of, to find, well, one dog I had to put down, he was 18, but my other 14-year-old, I found a beautiful home for him with another Course in Miracles student down El Paso. And it was so funny, I dropped off Oakley, and he has two dogs, and at night, we stayed up all night long. I was laying on his couch. He was in his chair. The lights were off, and we just talked Course and God and love. And he said at one point, he said, you know, the really silly thing about this is, he had two dogs plus now mine, and he was saying, I think I may be on the same path as you. What am I going to do with all the dogs? And I said, not to worry. We'll find homes for our dogs. You know, it's like that. What I really got for me, and this is a lifelong thing, my animals have always been a big veil between me and allowing myself to join with other human beings. I mean, they taught me how to love, and I'm very grateful for that. And it was time to allow them to go on and allow me to have the freedom to be up here. So, yeah, I'm from Santa Fe, but I'm really a part of this community. Whether or not they want me, it doesn't really matter.
Hi, I'm Karen from North Carolina, and I was here last year for a retreat and just
had an amazing love experience and have been studying the course ever since. And all of a sudden, I don't have words. It's just what my life is about. Is everything to me, and being with other mighty companions is just perfect. I don't know. That's all I have to say.
Thank you, Carol. Thank you.
My name's Luann, and I'm from Alberta, Canada. And I am here to undo and be. That's my goal.
Hi, I'm Nicholas. I'm a volunteer for this community. I've been here 2 years.
And a little louder, Nicholas.
My name is Nicholas. I'm a volunteer for the community. I've been here for 2 years, and I'm just here to serve and just be used by the Holy Spirit. It's so worth it.
Thank you. And we have you till Sunday night.
Yes.
Unless we really need you, we need to call you back.
I'll come right back. Yeah, just feels really beautiful being here with you all. And I was telling the people I was in the car, I'm so excited to pick you up. it just feels such a joy for me.
It's Saint Nicholas.
So thank you all, seriously.
Thank you, Nicholas.
Thanks, Nicholas.
Very first time I saw David on a video, the prayer of my heart became obvious, and it was that I wanted as well to lead a completely spirit-directed life. So when Spirit said move to Utah, I listened, and I've been here for 6 months, and it's
6 months.
So much healing. Incredible and unwinding, healing, expanding, getting stretched in ways that are really uncomfortable sometimes, and getting more and more surrendered and on my knees. And yeah, it's just beautiful. My companions rock. Yep. And I'm really grateful you're all here. It's lovely to share this space.
Thank you, Tamil.
My name is Elena. I was born in Colombia. I moved to Australia. And since I was a little girl, I've always wanted to serve God. I knew God without anybody teaching me that there was God. It's always been in my heart. And that's been my prayer every single day. God told me once that I would serve Him just by doing whatever I did, but with love. And that I should stay calm and just do whatever I do with love. But nevertheless, I still wanted to do more. And so I kept asking and praying to please guide me to a way or a place where I could finally devote my life entirely to God, to all of you. And in September last year, Spirit guided me to the Course in Miracles. I started reading it. I love it. And I thought that was it. A beautiful book. But then in February, God guided me to a video in which beautiful David was being interviewed. And I thought, oh, people can be teachers of the Course in Miracles. I didn't know that. I didn't know there were communities and anything like that. And then 2 weeks later, God told me, look, if David is coming to Sydney. I was in Sydney, Australia at the time. And I immediately went looking for it. And yeah, the first link, he was coming to Sydney in 2 weeks' time. And so I obviously said, okay, you want me to go and see him? Okay, I'll go. And I got there, and for 3 hours, he's answering questions, very nice. The people were lovely. But I kept asking Spirit, what is so important why I'm here? I don't really know. Because I never followed any person or nothing like that before. but it was very strong. And I kept asking why. Mm. And no, I didn't know. So at the very end, David is finishing the talk. And then I asked the Holy Spirit, I said, I still don't know what's the purpose of me being here. And something grabbed me and pulled me by the feet of David. And David just smiled and asked, what? Yeah, how can I help you? And I said, I just have another question. And then I told him that I didn't know of his existence until 3 weeks ago, and that I was there's always a purpose for everything. And I asked the Holy Spirit to tell me through David what was my purpose of being there. And after a brief conversation with David, he got the clarity and asked me to join him and help him in Mexico. And I said, I'd pause for a second, because Spirit had been telling me to go to another country. Mm-hmm. But it felt right. So I immediately said yes. And that's it. I resigned my job. And Spirit had other plans for me, so I didn't go to Mexico. I'm here. I arrived on Monday. And I'm very pleased to happily and happy to finally be of service. And to be joined with this beautiful family, my sisters and brothers in the light, whom I love forever, in eternity. Thank you so much.
Thank you. And Jesus got you a green card too. He just happened to drop a green card in. I met you in February and he just funk. After 17 years, was it?
My case is supposed to be due in 2 years' time. But Spirit had the other way and make it earlier, 2 years, earlier.
That's great. Yeah.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's Nancy, and I'm here with my husband, Philip. And I've been associated with Course in Miracles for many years. And Philip and I had a center. We called it Miracle Resource Center in Los Gatos, California. And we had many teachers and many groups and met so many beautiful people through the Course in Miracles. It's a wonderful vehicle for meeting mighty companions, as you say. And so I'm just grateful to be here and find out about this center and to be on this silent retreat. It's a very beautiful spiritual place. So thank you for providing this space.
Yeah,
totally.
I'll go next. I'm Tatsy, and I'm currently in Utah, although it's all totaled up to about 15 years when I've been in Utah. I just keep researching back, and I'm just so filled with love to be here. Being in this quiet and this sacred space surrounded by mighty companions and natural beauty, for me, is like a happy dream. So, thank you.
Thank you, Tatsy.
I'm so glad it's here.
My name is Scott. I'm here with my partner, Lisa. And I've always been a spiritually minded person, but was just introduced to the Course through Lisa last December or so, I guess, and there's stuff I don't know what to think about it, and there's stuff that I really feel the weight behind that, you know, the significance, and so even with our differences, we see our commonality in similarities and differences within spiritual traditions, so most recently, a couple weeks ago, we were just talking about silent retreats, and Lisa asked me, would you ever be interested in going on one? Have you ever been on one? It was just kind of a muse over lunch, and then we were reading reading something from the Way of Mastery, that, and I looked up online about it and came across some of your videos, David, and I was really just taken in by your presentation. And so I just started doing some Googling, and I came across your book, that there was this monastery. And right after one of your book tours, there was going to be a silent retreat. I looked, and I was like, it's next week. And so we talked, and we were just like, you know, because we're really trying, because Lisa and I can be overly serious in how we deal with life. And one of the things I really appreciate about you, David, is your lightness that you bring. Yes. Even without words, it comes through, and I feel like there's something there to tap into. And so... you know, we just talked about it, and then we were like, let's not overthink this. Let's just go. But it felt long, you know, and so, but as soon as you start thinking about it, you can start, get your teacher out, right, and you start figuring out, maybe I shouldn't for this one. But no, let's not do that. Let's just lean in.
Where did you come from?
From Arizona.
Arizona, okay.
From Arizona. So glad to be here with you all.
Thank you.
Thanks, Scott.
I'm Lisa from Phoenix also, and it's very spur of the moment that I ended up here. The deepest desire of my heart for many, many years has been to awaken to the truth, to my true identity. I remember being a little girl and being maybe 7, 8 years old and being so clear, knowing that this world wasn't my home, and very confused, like, what, you know, where's God? What happened? and having this knowing that this is not my home, but then being in an environment with a family that was very much about this is life, this is, you know, who you are, and I became very afraid and very alone and very sad. And you know, got lost deeper into the dream until a lot of darkness, and that awakened me back up to my spiritual path. I'm very aware of the ego mind within me, and I know I'm asleep, and I walk around knowing that I'm asleep, wondering, does anybody else know that they're asleep? Does anybody else? And I watch myself, and I watch that I want to hold on to this identity that I made up. I see my cherishing of it. I see the words coming out of my mouth that I want to let it go, and I see my awareness of it, yet I don't let it go. And I just feel very blessed, actually, that my partner, who's not been studying the course at all, and I, who've been studying the course for quite a while, that he is the catalyst to bring us here.
He's a keeper.
Within myself is the lightness of spirit that I feel. The ego mind in me is super serious.
Super serious.
Yeah.
She's wonderful.
And I want to let it go. I want to let the obstacles in my mind go. I've been aware of them. I've been holding them. Being with all of you together, joining together, I know, gives me a place where there's so much potential beyond my limited self, and I'm just grateful to be here with all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My name is Jamie, and I am visiting from Panama. And I had a trip planned. My little sister and her husband are having just had their first baby. And so I had a trip planned up to Washington, D.C. to be there. And it was I didn't have a return ticket. And my mom was also moving up to D.C. at the same time, and my mom is alone, and so the idea was for me to go up there and, you know, be Aunt Jamie and help mom move and everything. And I kind of serendipitously found out that there was this retreat right at the end of the time when I would be going back anyway. And so I was like, well, this is obviously meant to be. And it was a very strong pull. Yeah, James, you're going to this. This is happening. This is what's next for you on this path with the course, and you know, meeting a sangha of people, because in Panama, there's a small group of us. There are four of us that have a little group, but to be able to meet, wow, this, you know, gathering of people, and to be here and just feel like you're all, even though I've never met you, you know, physically before, it's like you're my dearest friends. Mm. And going around and giving everyone hugs, and it's just like, oh my gosh, these people, it's amazing. So thank you. I'm just honored to be here and super excited about what is going to unfold for me and for all of us.
Thank you, Jamie.
Thank you. I'm Mitha. I'm from Northern California, Sonoma County, north of San Francisco. And I've been to a couple of weekends that David has done in Marin and Sonoma there. And been studying the course started about 10 years ago, but seriously for the last couple of years. But I came because I hit a lot of resistance when I tried to go to that place of stillness. Uh-huh. And that's what I want for this week, is to go past that resistance to that place of stillness. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, my name's Andy. I think it was last Monday, I had a really strong urge to travel somewhere.
Oh.
And then, I didn't know where. And then later that day, I went to a meditation, and at the end of the meditation, we always draw these cards. And I told Spirit, please give me some guidance on whatever card I pick. And I picked the card out of the deck, and it said, it's time to go. And then I looked at the Living Miracle schedule. I saw the silent retreat. I asked Nick, what do you think of it? He said, well, it's full at the moment, but we'll keep it in prayer and see what happens. And I think a day later, I had sent an email, the question for the show with David and Francis. And David answered my question. And then right afterwards, he said, by the way, I know everyone said the retreat is full. You can definitely take like 20 more
minutes. People were calling me saying, did you hear what David said? Did you hear it? We were full, right?
Were you guys watching over here?
No, I just heard I got called. Like, you know what David just said? And I said, great. And then the call started coming, and it was really beautiful.
I think I talked to her. She said something about it. She said, of course, the campground. We always have the campground. And I said, of course we have the campground. So then Jesus,
I bought the plane ticket like 2 or 3 days ago, and I showed up.
Where are you from?
Where are you from?
Maryland, Washington, D.C.
Welcome, geez. Andy.
Welcome. Like, you're coming.
And you and Nicholas know each other, right?
Yeah, from high school.
Bright lights.
He's the angel that showed up in my life when I was in my darkest time.
You guys are so great. What's your combined age?
44.
44. The go. Here comes the new generation.
Thank you.
I was introduced to the course probably in the late 90s and wasn't ready for it. I reacquainted myself with it in January, tried lots of things previous to that, and never was able to shake the story fully. Kind of got a handle on it, but I'd always thought that my ego was a savior up until I was about 20. And ever since, I've been trying to lose it. So I felt the rightness of this. It really resonated well with me on the mind part of it, being an analytical thinker also. So I'm really grateful to be here with you all. I can honestly say this is a very powerful room. And thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ray.
Thank you, Ray.
My name's Susan, and I'm from Oregon, but originally from British Columbia, Canada. Mm. Okay. And this is my first time here, my first time at a silent retreat. Been studying Course in Miracles for a number of years with the group, which is where I met Liliana. And I heard about the course from Liliana. She had already signed up for it, and I hadn't heard of it at all before. But I had for several years, over a period of several years, I had from time to time looked for a silent retreat. So when she mentioned this, I was quite interested. What's going on in my life right now? What would I want to get out of this? I feel like I'm on the edge of a whole lot of really big decisions. And I'm feeling pulled in a lot of different directions at one time. So I would really like to get some clarity around that and you know, to be able to go deep. So much of what everybody else has said also is true for me. Wanting to make that connection, that deep connection internally. And here's some answers that are better than the answers, the ones I come up with myself.
My name is Philip. I'm here with Nancy, my wife. We were married once for over 12 years, and then we split up for that long, and recently got back together and remarried. So we're newlyweds for about 8 days. We've been in the car so long, it's longer than the two 22-year-olds. I realized recently that being raised as a very serious Catholic with two priest brothers and lots of Jesuit education, I learned how to look good in life better than I learned anything. And I think it's really gotten in my way of the course. I never have felt that I did the lessons properly. At the end, I was somehow shortchanging the lessons, wasn't getting it. But what I realized when I saw this retreat was coming up, I was in touch with Suzanne and recognized that being raised Catholic in the way that I was, one is better at guilt and shame and fear than anything else. And one is always measuring themselves. I stopped going to confession many, many years ago, but it's still there. And once I signed up for this retreat, I developed a serious heart problem. I had my heart shocked twice. Wow. So started on a bunch of medications when I never thought I had any kind of a problem. And I can see it's all focusing on my ego saying, you ain't gonna go nowhere. But I am. Already started.
Thank you.
My name is Diane, and I'm originally from Northern California. Catholic, Dominican.
Heavy duty. Just as bad.
Yeah. And I found the course at the Golden Break bookstore, just walking through, bumping around like a ping pong ball in a windstorm. And there it was, and I picked it up, and I wasn't ready for it. And then I came back to it, with David to Camus, but I had started it. I had started it about a year before, and then Tatsy was in Nevada, and we were talking back and forth a couple of times a week, and it's such an honor to be here with you, and listen to the honesty. I don't have to say anything, you're saying it, you know. We're one, we're joined, and it's just about love and laughter and light and being honest and listening, truly listening. And I work with children in Park City, Utah. Tatsy's actually there too. And they tell me every day, I have to come to learn to listen. To love myself. Let go of all that wonderful teaching. Thank you. It's an honor.
Thank you, Diane.
Okay. I want to say that too.
Okay, you can go to
I am so grateful to be here. After all that resistance and all that great, great contrast, to know that I don't know anything and to be okay with I don't know anything because it's going to be better. Even though I don't know. But I trust it, and I'm so grateful. I feel like I already know you, and I just reach out to you when I need to, but I try to listen to the Holy Spirit and get that try not to try thing. Mm-hmm. I try not to get in the way of listening, and I really don't want to talk. Unless it's the Holy Spirit talking. And I see that with you, David. And I see the way you do it. And sometimes it comes through, but I really am happy to be here with you. I was afraid to come. I wanted to come for a whole year, but then I saved my money and everything. And then... 3 days ago, I'm like, oh, what am I doing? I can't do this. And I got scared because there are so many people coming, but mm-hmm. I like being with all of you because I can relate to what everyone said mm-hmm. perfectly. So I love being here.
What's your name?
I'm from Philadelphia area.
My name is Marsha, and I'm from Maine. Scared to death to be here. I've never even been on a retreat, a spiritual retreat. I studied the course for a number of years. I came across David's teachings and was drawn to his presence. And I'd like some clarity in my life, and I'd really like an experience instead of just understanding the concept.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
So I think that's why I'm here. I need something to show me. That I can get some answers on some questions that I need. And I want them to be mine, not my answers, but the Holy Spirit speaking through me because my answers aren't right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Marsha.
So my name is Bev, and I'm from Alberta, Canada. Mm-hmm. And I can actually access stillness for short periods of time, but I can't sustain it. So I wanted to join with the Mighty Companions because having one purpose, I'm hoping will give me some sustaining power there.
Mm.
So I love nature. I love nature. So I'm here to spend a lot of time outside and be quiet.
And
mm-hmm.
be quiet. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mm. I'm so grateful to be here.
Your toes show it.
She's wagging
it. So when really, like you guys have been saying, I mean, I listen to all of you,
yeah,
and it's my story that you are saying, but it comes against here. It's like you've said it. We're all so much the same. It's incredible. Oh, and y'all are looking at me, and it's like, oh, me looking at myself. I love you. I'm here with my dear friend from Culebra, Puerto Rico.
Oh, thank you.
Anyway, I decided to come. I asked the Holy Spirit, okay, you have to show me a sign that I'm going to Utah. And I watch movies on a little android like this. And the little android decided not to do the touch, you know, how you touch it and it
you know, you pick this movie, you pick that movie. It would not do anything. It wouldn't even turn off. I was on Netflix. And then this movie popped up, and I said, there was no way. I couldn't turn it off, couldn't change. And I said, I want to watch a movie, so I guess I'm going to watch this. It was not, and it was about Utah. Maybe a more clearer. Yeah,
thank you.
Hey, my name is James, and I just feel so honored to welcome you all, and just to see all these beautiful smiling faces and feel all this devotion. Yeah. I don't really have a lot else to say, which is... this is the style. So thanks for coming.
Thank you.
And sharing in this deep purpose that the Holy Spirit has got for us all.
Where are you from, James?
I'm from heaven.
I can confirm that.
That's good. Everyone will be curious about your accent now. Like,
do they all talk
quadrant
like that?
In heaven.
Right. Northwest heaven.
Northwest.
Northwest. My name's Kelly, and I'm from Phoenix, Arizona as well. I've been studying the course for about 3 years, and just in the recent past have started feeling some huge insights and miracles, and then slammed the door on that because I felt just an intense amount of resistance. So this is me trying to kind of melt a little bit of that away and take it to the next level. So I felt like coming here was the way to do it, and I appreciate David's uncompromising approach, which... which I'm very grateful for that, and I appreciate everyone for joining. So thank you.
Thank you.
My name is Julie. I'm quite shy about speaking, and I had a red-eye flight last night, so I'm quite tired. I don't know if I can speak coherently, but I'll try. I'm from the U.S., but I live in Central Europe, and I don't know anybody else. I've been studying the course for, 3 years, maybe longer, but more intensively as time goes on. I don't know anybody where I live who studies the course, so I've longed to be with a group of people who speak the language and live it. And I do have a very solid spiritual community there, but it's not, they don't know the course, or they know of it only. And I was in California for a month-long inquiry program, and I longed to go deeper into silence, and I was looking at all these different monasteries or temples or someplace in the area, and I realized this was happening. I looked into your schedule, and but the dates kind of overlap with two things, but it almost fit. And I thought, no, it can't work, you know, because I... Mm-hmm. But anyway, I'm really surprised to be here. Suddenly I found a compromise, a way around it. And just a couple days ago, I booked the flight.
Thank you.
Well, I'm Liliana. I came here from Portland, Oregon, a few days ago, and have quite a few ties to Ecuador, where I lived many years. And I just am so grateful for the YouTube talks that you give, David. It just made the Course in Miracles meaningful and real for me. I love to talk. I love to listen. I love to sing. Just everything, many, many words. So I thought, okay, maybe you need to be quiet. We'll see what happens. So that's why I'm here, and to worship and to share with all of you and I'm so impressed is the wrong word, but I'm so touched by people communicating and really opening up and putting on the altar whatever it is, an experience that is coming up, so that we can be clean. We can clean ourselves and be ready to know who it is we are. Mm-hmm. So I like more of that. Mm-hmm. It's just so grateful to be here for all of you.
Thank you, Lillian.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, my name is Dylan, and I just really love the sacredness and holiness that I feel in this community. First time I came here was the second strawberry, I think. And I tend to be shy to speak, but not when I move. Mm-hmm. I speak very loudly. And when I saw the announcement that there was going to be a silent retreat, I love to spend time in silence and prayer. And I thought, oh, I really want to go, but I don't know if I'm going to, you know, life and finances, all that stuff is going to happen. And I kept feeling this tickling in my stomach that I'm supposed to go. And I said, I don't know how this is going to happen this time around. And I think I contacted Suzanne and said I wanted to come. And I was, you know, getting all excited to go. And this was like a couple of weeks before I was going to try to book a flight and get it out here. I had like this tooth extraction I had to get done, and I didn't even know I had any pain. I didn't even know there was this dead tooth that was infected. I didn't even have a clue what was going on. But it ate up the cost of what my plane fare would be. So I just told Suzanne I still wanted to come, but I didn't know how that was going to happen. Well, in the meantime, part of my practice with the course is I do Tai Chi every day, and I do it out in our yard, and I do it for myself, or if anybody wants to come, there could be 10, 12 people come free. I don't charge anybody, or it could just be me. Most of the time it's me, you know, but whoever comes are welcome to come. And I've been doing my Tai Chi, and I was literally praying for the community that they would feel the love that I feel for God when I'm in prayer or when I'm moving. And I don't know what happened. It was like the next day, something came in. A client came in. I do healing touch and stuff like that. And I had accumulated enough money to get the plane ticket in a couple of days. So I booked the ticket. I think Tamara called and asked if I was going to come. And I booked the ticket. And I said, wow, well, there's part of it. And then Suzanne and Tamara called, and I'm not even sure, we were trying to work out the payments to come, and asked if I knew something. I'm not even sure how it came about if I knew somebody that did movement. Or I said, yeah. So here I am.
Wow. Yes. Yay. You will gift us in the morning with a Tai Chi. Yeah. It's beautiful. Thank you, Devon. Yeah, so good to have you. I could feel it. Definitely.
You would not believe how many times the sun would burst open every time I was doing it, praying. It was just like, oh. It was so beautiful.
So I'm Karen, and I'm from Washington. And in the spirit of wanting to shift the energy in me, I get real nervous being witnessed by a lot of people. Saying that to release that.
Thank you. Yeah, let it go. Yeah.
So I am bubbling inside with so much excitement to be silent. It's so deep for me because I've been holding this whole retreat like it's a drink of water for my soul, for my being. What else is there to say? I'm holding that it's going to be a deepening so I can become more fluent at listening.
I'm Kirsten, and I'm from Colorado, and I've never done a silent retreat. I was in Estes Park in June and met David and a couple of other people, and it was really great. It was a really nice time, and so I started listening to a lot more of David's talks online, and I've been so grateful for that because I don't have a community that there's no course community where I live either, and so I just was reading on my own, and I would listen to some other course teachers, and then after this June retreat, it was every day I was listening to David. I started going through the workbook lessons that he has online, and it just made me feel like I was such a part of. I didn't feel alone doing it anymore. Mm-hmm. And then listening to all of you tonight, now, it's like I had so much fear. I didn't think I had fear coming here until I was driving up the gravel road. And then it came full bore, and I get afraid of people, like I don't want to let you in, you know. But listening to everybody, it's like I hear you guys say what's on my mind so much that I feel the love, and I really feel like I can let it in. So, I'm really looking forward to going deeper and just letting some things go that fear, you know, that fear. I just hold on to so much fear, and I really want to let it go and just let God in and have that light and laughter, you know. And I feel that every now and then, and it's like, oh, I know it's there, and I don't want to be so serious. I know that feeling. Really looking forward to the week, and I'm so glad we did this. It's so great. It makes me feel so close to everybody, like we're all one. So thank you.
Thank you, Kristen.
Hello, everyone. My name is Alexa. I came here from California, Los Angeles. I too was at the Estes Park retreat. But even before that, I just get from a few years with the course, but as soon as I opened it, it was like all I had ever known. And it was just an immediate awareness of everything I've ever known. Since I've my first memories of being here at like 2 years old. I had an interesting backstory, which it will not happen right now, but needless to say, my mom was a nun, and my dad didn't really believe in God at all, so it was very interesting. So just from the moment that I kind of came into the, my aunt, who was a nun as well, is the one that gave me the course, and just submerged myself in every teaching I could find and everyone I really resonated with. And David and the messengers were one, we were just talking, remembering like one of the first periscopes I think you guys did. They were like sitting on the couch on the computers and stuff. I was there, like, I felt part of this community just like so intensely, and just have felt so connected. And in Estes Park, just kind of how I got here was, I got this fortune cookie for meals, and it said in 3 months from this date, like, amazing things are going to be happening, or happiness or something is going to be unfolding. And I was like, oh, that's nice. And I was thinking of the date, and I was like, oh, that's right before my birthday. And then I met with Diana and Sarah, and they were like, oh, and we're having a silent retreat right then too. And so I think that you should ask for that for your birthday and come out and be part of it. So it kind of unfolded. And then with Kirsten, and it's kind of how I ended up here. And then what I really, I just, from that moment, it was the weekend of Freedom Retreat, and I remember just talking to David and saying, I feel an acceleration, and I just surrender. Like, I just totally felt the surrender. And from that point, which was three months ago, literally almost all of my, everything I've ever known has fallen away. Has just been shedding and shedding, just every single thing, relationships and home and career, and just every self-concept is melting. And so I'm in the point of one of the last transitions of that, or well, not the last obviously, but one of the major ones. And I'm here because there's no other place I'd rather be, and I just know that this is what I'm supposed to be. So I'm here for the clarity, and I just want to be a clear channel. I just want to hear it and be used through And I'm so grateful to all of you.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Janelle. I'm originally from Puerto Rico. I think you too. I've been living in Florida for 10 years. I'm a single mother of three children. The way why I'm here, it's a long story. But since I'm a little girl, I've been feeling like a strong calling, and I have been seeing manifestations, like real. My dad was a very abusive person, and my mother, like totally opposite, but didn't relate to us. And although we struggle a lot, I never felt like lack of love. And they never took me to church, never, never. They never told me what's God. They never told me, go read the Bible. And I remember going outside and just looking to the skies and hearing inside me like something telling me, I'm with you. And I'm like, am I crazy? I don't know. And that's a long story, but let me tell you how I came here. February 17, I'm at church. I was trying to build a business in fitness and health. And I was writing a book and developing applications. And I thought I was like, woo, I'm going to make this very successful business. And I can buy like a big house to my children because I'm a single mom. And I'm just at church just praying and thanking God. I'm like, oh my God, this is so done, so perfect. I know you're going to bless me with this. And I heard something in my heart. And he said, this is not the way I want you to be known by. And I just stopped. Everything stopped. The music in church, everything's like a silent. And I'm like this, and I start crying. And my daughter, my oldest daughter, she's by my side. And she's like, what's going on, Mom? I cannot stop crying. Then that night, I went home. And I believe it's the Holy Spirit. He told me to write this. He said, a man is prisoner of his own divinity until he expresses his freedom through the wonders of God in his own life. Mm-hmm. And he told me what to do. And since then, I stopped my business. And I'm doing what he told me to do. But the way I came here, I was just going through my emails. And I normally erase like spams. And I'm just like checking to the list. And I see this that says Living Miracles Retreat, whatever. I'm like, what is that? And I click to open, and I open, and I start reading. And I'm like, and something told me, you have to go. I'm like, I don't even know who they are. It's a scam. They might probably get my money. I'm like, and then I contact Michael Caruso.
Yeah.
And then he called me immediately, and I'm like, this is a spam. Nobody calls you like that. I'm like, really? And he started talking with his accent, you know, very pretty. I'm like,
Australian. An Australian accent.
I'm like, pretty. You're selling it. You're buying well, and you're selling it well, I said. And then I said, okay, I'm convinced, but I have no money and I have no vacation because I'm working right now as an accountant. And he said, figure it out, talk to your boss, whatever. And I'm like, okay, great. I hang up, I went to my boss. My boss is fat. And I immediately rushed to her office. I say, I have to talk to you. Like this. And she's like, are you okay? I'm like, mm-mm. I need to go away for a week. For what? And I just hang up to a guy I don't know. He told
told me about this retreat in silent. She's a silent? Yeah. And I have to go. And she said, go for it. I'm like, oh my God, really? She said, yeah, go. Go for it. And then, okay, I'm like, yeah, I'm going. I have no money. I have no money. So immediately, everything like after the other, I went through my Facebook just to get my mind, like, and I see this girl who just posted something that said, GoFundMe. I'm like, that's it, GoFundMe. So I immediately opened the account, GoFundMe. And in 3 days, three friends pay for my flight ticket. Whoa. And the deposit. Wow.
God fund me.
And I'm like, okay, I'm here. But God always talked to me. It's like very clear, but with the kids it's different. Like, you know, it's difficult to hear. And I know he has to tell me something big. No. And hopefully I can share with you.
Yeah.
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 Thank you. Thank you.
I'm blessed to be here.
Thank you.
My name is Katie, and I'm from Toronto, Canada. And this year, I've been tuning into the LM Virtual, and I see these people, and they're talking, like, I love it when you guys talk, but then I think it's not possible to experience it. So then I had this feeling that I should apply to come to the community and see, to experience it myself. Mm-hmm. And I deleted, and then I cried, and I deleted, and I cried. And the third time, I remember one show, David said, you just do it. You just apply, and we'll welcome you. And I thought, oh, my God. Okay, so and then I applied, and Michael and Kirsten called, and I said, yeah, I want to come. Because I really want to listen and hear directly God's voice. I think it's for some special people like you guys. Mm. Not me, I can't hear. Yeah.
You're special.
So then I really want to be in silence and just allow myself like to be loved. Like I just want to be loved.
Mm. You are loved.
Connected.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
So my name is Laura, and I'm currently residing in Culebra, Puerto Rico with my two sweet friends. And I am really, this is such a huge heart calling to be here. And from the moment I discovered and followed through and filled out the application, which deleted.
Oh, I know.
Three times. No, on the third time it came through. But we were wanting to walk. We were thinking we were going to go to Spain to do the El Camino. Mm-hmm. And then this all came through, and I saw Utah. I was like, wow, I can walk in Utah. and then the whole monastery thing, and then the whole going deeper thing, and then going into the volunteer thing. That was just, you know, and then talking to Michael. And then it was just like, there was just the silence, and it was like, it was just this go home thing that just felt so big. And here we are, experiencing home. So thank you.
Thank you.
My name is Liz, and I came from Vermont, but live in Puerto Rico most of the time. And I heard about you, David, from Dion and Laura. And before that, I started meditating in 1971. And that was for medical reasons, migraine headaches. Some brilliant doctor said,
think you should meditate. I think that would help you. And it was like it opened up the world for me. And in those meditations, I understood myself a little better. As a child, I wanted to go to every single church. I'd see a church, I'd go, Mom, what's that? That's a Episcopalian church. Can we go there? And she'd go, okay. And so I think I was saved by almost every church. Mormons included. And, but the meditation put me someplace different. And so I've been doing that and got into Zen meditation and probably close to 30 years. I've done several silent retreats or shashins and struggled through some parts of it and just felt at home during other parts of it. Just like really grounded and out of my body at the same time. It was an experience that I wanted to keep doing. And then there were bits of life that pulled me off in different directions. And both of my grandmothers were into metaphysical stuff, mom's side and dad's side. And I inherited books, old hardcover books. And like I'd read little bits of it and go, oh, that's so interesting. And when my grandmother died in 1986, I inherited a book that said A Course in Miracles. And I started reading it, and I said, this is interesting. It, it's sort of like Buddhism. I sort of feel that, and I sort of resonate with some of it. And then I put it away and started studying with other teachers, too, along with doing my Buddhist meditation bit. And lo and behold, one of my friends that I was studying with, or in a community with, said, Liz, will you help me? I need somebody to organize and get things together for this person that I've met, and I really am enjoying taking courses with him and reading his books, and it was Gary Renard. And I said, sure, why not? And I sat through that first one in total resistance. I said, how can you listen to him? His voice is so squeaky. And he goes, why are you listening with those ears? I said, yeah, okay. So then I did another one for him. And so that got me into it, but not, I didn't feel the community part of it. I didn't get that part. And every time I would go to Culebra, Puerto Rico, I just wanted the community to be, spiritual and just loving because it needs it there. I need it there. And so listening to your voice, it wasn't squeaky. It was just... It just resonated, and so they told me about the retreat, and I said, I think so. Mm-hmm. And then I went to work in Vermont, and I was, 2 weekends ago, I was helping another workshop friend of mine, Michael Tamara, and I said, I'm going to go to a silent retreat with David Hoffmeister, and goes, oh, you're going to have a great time. I said, it's a silent retreat. And he goes, Liz. And I said, yeah, I'm going to come out of this finding out how to silently laugh so loud that the universe hears it. So that's why I'm here.
From Iceland, but I live in Denmark. Mm. I have talked to God and to Jesus all my life, but I only been studying the course since January this year. And it hit me quite hard. In a lot of healing, and immediately I began to hear the voice of Holy Spirit. And in June this year, I was strongly guided to go to a retreat in Holland. And I have never in my life traveled on my own, so I had a lot of resistance. But I went, and then I went to a retreat in Spain as well. And it's my first time in the USA. And I'm so grateful to be here with all of you. So much love and light. And I'm looking forward to this week.
Well, I think we're out of time.
There's always time for you, Jeffrey.
No such thing.
No such thing.
Yeah, I honestly don't know how I got here. I don't. I got to the course through the stepping stone of recovery. And there's a saying, it says, stay in the middle of the herd. And I think this qualifies. You know, I actually sat here when we were going to pass the mic, and I'm like, should I move back to my chair? And I'm like, no, I like it here. But this is it. Last year I sat in Love's Nest, and I made a prayer, and my prayer is the same now. It was, you know, I lay down my dream as a holy son of God, and rising up as he created me, dispense with idols and remember him. And it's still my prayer today. And I do it with these guys on my shoulders. It's like, how can I be this lucky? You know, it's amazing. And this is actually my first silent retreat too, so it should be interesting. But truly grateful to be here. So, thank you for all being here.
Have a breaking the silence at the end to do a circle of
Yes.
Yeah, I just want to share. I'm Kirsten and I haven't met everyone individually yet. I've been in a very, very quiet place the last I don't know how long. So it just feels really perfect to invite you all into it, to join me. Because it's so precious, and it really is our natural state to have our mind be empty and quiet, and to be in that hush, like the hush of heaven. I know it's something that you can't personally make happen. And it's not something that you have personal control over. And yet, it can be desired. And it can be nurtured. And we can give this desire to be in touch with it, our full attention, and let it be our purpose. And I'm so grateful that I was told when I first began meditating, and I came to that through migraine headaches, I had to find that stillness beyond pain. And I was told by my meditation teacher, a monk, he said, it's better for you than sleeping, meditation. That was really beautiful gift to be told, because I had a lot of concern around wanting to sleep, which really was just wanting rest, wanting the quiet, wanting time out away from this world and this mind. And I was told that no matter how busy my mind was when I was meditating, that was irrelevant. I was meditating, I was meditating. And it was better for me than sleep. That took the pressure off. And then the Spirit's guidance has been from there to allow life to become a meditation. And it's just about letting go of whatever resistance is in the mind, moment by moment, day by day, so that your mind can eventually just really feel like water, like it can just flow with whatever. You don't need anything from this world to flow and be in the peace. You don't need anything to be different. You don't need the environment to be a certain way. So it's just the greatest gift to have this conscious process and practice and pathway to be able to come into the true stillness, the peace that can't be disturbed, because that's our goal. Also very, very grateful to be here. And have this gift of a retreat just laid out before us.
Feel such a heartfelt invitation from the Spirit for everybody to just be. Don't try to do this right. Just be. Just truly, truly rest your mind. Give yourself the gift of that deep rest. Don't try to figure anything out. We have you. We have you. We have you. And it truly is our honor to give in this way to you. You're safe, and you are at home. So I just keep hearing, just rest your minds, rest your bodies. Let yourself be carried by others for a change. Allow that love to find you, to soothe you, and to be with you, that you're worthy of it, that you are it. Just rest. There's a depth here. We felt it tonight with this group. There's a depth of devotion. There's a maturity. Thank you. So what we'd like to do is just play you a very beautiful song to take us into the silence. This is where we will officially let the words go.